From Hollywood to your hometown, this is Celebrity Page TV. We're keeping you informed on everything happening in the world of entertainment. I'm Sonya Isabel, coming to you from our New York City newsroom.
And I'm James Vaughn, working remotely, keeping you covered on the West Coast. Here's what's on today's episode.
She's the queen of everything, including clean eating. Today, the one and only Oprah Winfrey tells us her secret to staying healthy.
Also, is anyone in Hollywood busier than Raven Simone? We're one-on-one with the actress talking her new movies, her new TV special, and her new marriage.
Plus, the latest on getting daytime dramas back into production from the experts at Soap Opera Digest.
We're so glad you're with us, so let's kick things off with a special book club edition of The Hollywood Wrap.
I think it's the best way to get to know me. Is to get to know my mind.
Looking for a great summer read?
Yeah, sure.
Now some of our favorite athletes, musicians, actors, and game show hosts are releasing brand new books, including a new memoir from comedian Jim Carrey that's much like Jim himself, part real, part made up.
I slice myself in two and lay on a rock and let the gulls pull my entrails out.
Memoirs and Misinformation is out now.
I'm doing well. I've been continuing my treatment. And it is paying off, though it does fatigue me a great deal.
Speaking of memoirs, Jeopardy host Alex Trebek has just released one of his own. The answer is Reflections on My Life, taking us inside Trebek's personal life, including his ongoing battle with pancreatic cancer. There's even an audio version read by Alex and Jeopardy great Ken Jennings. Both are available now. Also just released one of the last projects the late Kobe Bryant worked on. It's the book Geese Are Never Swans, the latest in a young adult series Kobe created to encourage young athletes never to give up on their dreams. And for something completely different, there's a new tell-all biography from the man who played drums behind Billy Joel for 30 years. Liberty DeVito sharing with Hollywood insider Arthur Cade about the highs and lows of his career and his very public split with Billy.
Tell me all about putting it into a book.
It started out as me being the angry old man, you know, just putting down things that I remember and why did he do this and how could he do this to me and all kinds of things like that. But then as time went by, I matured, I hope, and with the help of a life coach, I started to look at the person Billy Joel, and let me find out why he did what he did.
It appears the two have at least somewhat reconciled since Billy wrote the foreword for the new book. Liberty, Life, Billy, and the Pursuit of Happiness is out now. Happy reading. That's today's Hollywood Wrap.
Raven Simone is busier than ever. She's a newlywed, she's also in a new movie, and she's part of a huge crossover event on Disney Channel. Today, she's spilling all the tea in this one-on-one.
Yep, that's me.
Disney fans of Raven Simone following her career since her early days on That's So Raven.
Yep, that's us.
Since 2017, the star reprising her role in the Disney Channel hit, Raven's Home.
The first emotion is, dang, I've been a part of the first one, and now the most recent, nice bookend, Cool Beans.
Welcome to Camp Kikiwaka.
Camp Kikiwaka.
Now Raven and her castmates are visiting the Bunked set in the crossover special, Raven About Bunked.
The Raven's Home cast sets off on a road trip that gets a little messed up. Their GPS doesn't take them quite where they thought they would end up, and they end up meeting me and all of my friends at Camp Kikiwaka.
And I'm coming at it from a different perspective, not the child, but the adult. It's okay to grow up and still have a good time.
Where did you find this kid?
The actress also busy on the big screen in her latest film, Mighty Oak.
I was a huge fan of hers because I had watched That's So Raven, like every single episode I've seen.
I'm so lucky to be a part of this film. And everyone, they're so nice.
I would do anything for Brookwell McNamara. They started That's So Raven in the very beginning. I love Mighty Oak. It's such a good movie.
The movie is available now on demand. But we didn't see this coming. Raven secretly marrying her wife, Miranda Madej.
I'm enjoying myself fully in quarantine, happily, newlywed, trying my best to stay on the up and up, knowing that there's so many people going through so much as the world changes. We have to change with it.
Congratulations, Raven. You can watch Raven About Bunked starting July 24th on Disney Channel.
I love that, Raven. Now onto some other celebrity stories making headlines. For that, we are checking in with Us Weekly's Christina Garibaldi. She's got the very latest. Hey, Christina, it's good to see you. So what stories are you following?
Yeah, we're starting out with some big news about Ellen DeGeneres. So there was this bombshell report that came out on BuzzFeed where a bunch of former and current staffers came forward saying that it was a toxic work environment to work on the Ellen DeGeneres show. Now, some of the executive producers have come forward apologizing, saying that they're going to do better and will do better in the future. But a lot of these employees say that this kind of weighs on Ellen since she is the face of the show. She has not responded to the claims, but a source told us that she was hoping that this would go away, but clearly it has not. And we got some big royal news. Princess Beatrice is a married woman. She married Eduardo Mapelli Mosey on July 17th in a secret ceremony. Nobody knew about this. Nobody knew it was coming. She married at Windsor Castle. And of course, with the coronavirus pandemic, there was just 20 people in attendance, including Queen Elizabeth. Despite it being a small affair, it was a lovely affair and everybody had a really great time. And the pictures were beautiful. She wore a recycled dress from the Queen and the Queen's tiara that the Queen wore when she married Prince Philip. So everybody was well represented, well celebrated, and we wish the happy couple nothing but the best.
Well, Christina, as always, thanks so much. For more stories like these, be sure to pick up the latest issue of Us Weekly.
It's time for today's See Her Spotlight, brought to you by WW Weight Watchers Reimagined. Each week, our See Her Celebrity Spotlight series celebrates women in the entertainment industry who are bringing talent and authenticity to the roles they take on and off screen. Led by the Association of National Advertisers, See Her is the leading global movement for gender equality in ads and media. If you can see her, you can be her. Well, this week, we're highlighting the one and only Oprah Winfrey. Here's today's See Her Spotlight. From running her own media empire to new projects with Apple TV Plus and even her Oscar-nominated acting career, Oprah Winfrey continues to inspire across all mediums. Another longtime passion of Oprah's, wellness.
When you start to change the attitude and change your mindset, you begin to change what's happening in your life.
The media mogul helping people everywhere with her recent four-part live virtual experience, Your Life in Focus, A Vision Forward. The virtual experience allowing viewers to gain wisdom and motivation straight from Oprah herself.
You teach people how to treat you, so you tell them what your time limits are, what your boundaries are, what you can do, what you cannot do. And that's what this moment is here to evolve us to.
Oprah using meditation, gratitude, and an interactive workbook that helps viewers achieve their goals.
Focusing on what you can control and what you can't, because worry, as you know, doesn't change anything.
Well said, Oprah. Get more tips and tricks on healthy living in person or virtually and start your wellness journey with a trained expert WW coach by checking out workshops at WW.com. And for more information, go to seeher.com or visit @seeher2020. Today's See Her Spotlight was brought to you by WW Weight Watchers Reimagined builds healthy habits for real life. See how the new customized My WW program is proven to make weight loss easier.
On the award-winning WW app, you can take a personal assessment and get matched with a customized plan.
The assessment takes into account the things that matter to you the most.
On my plan, whole wheat pasta and potatoes are 0 points.
On the app, we love the personalized recipes.
We found so many new favorites.
With 24/7 live coaching, you get connected to an amazing coach who can answer any question that you might have.
I lost 91 pounds. It's the best thing I could have ever done.
WW, Weight Watchers Reimagined.
Can I tell you a cat joke? Just kidding.
Why did the girl ask the mushroom to dance?
Because he was a fun guy.
What do you call a pig that knows karate?
Pork chop.
So how does a tissue dance? Put a little boogie on it.
On the next Celebrity Page TV, we're chatting with Will Ferrell about his new Netflix comedy, plus OG Ghostbusters star Ernie Hudson. Big stars, big Hollywood, Celebrity Page TV. Welcome back to Celebrity Page TV. It's time to download all the newest movies and shows. Here's today's dish.
Hi, I'm Emily Blunt. I am the voice of Zoe.
And I'm John Krasinski, the voice of Owen in the new animated movie, Animal Crackers.
Even with movie theaters still closed, it's another busy week of new releases, including the animated film, Animal Crackers. The A-list cast of voices includes Danny DeVito, Sylvester Stallone, Ian McKellen, and Raven Simone. The story about magical cookies that turn people into wildlife is streaming now on Netflix.
Sorry about you and Noah.
We didn't break up, though.
With different zip codes, breakups are basically automatic.
Automatic.
Sometimes I hate high school.
Also on Netflix, it's the much-anticipated sequel, The Kissing Booth 2. Emmy nominee Joey King is back, but this time her boyfriend Noah is away at college. You don't have to wait to see if their love survives. The movie is streaming now.
I want to tell you about radium.
A most peculiar and remarkable element.
Over on Amazon Prime, the story of Marie Curie is brought to life in the new film Radioactive. Oscar nominee Rosamund Pike playing the Nobel Prize winning scientist. It's streaming now.
What's going on?
I don't know.
If you're looking for something scarier, there's The Rental, directed by Dave Franco and starring his real-life wife, Alison Brie. Or there's the mysterious thriller, Amulet. Both are now available on demand.
Nobody wants to be called a tourist. Tourist sounds like something you'd accuse someone of being.
On the TV side, comedian Jim Gaffigan has a brand new stand-up special. The Pale Tourist is streaming now on Prime Video. While over at Quibi, Kevin Hart and Andy Cohen both have new shows, Kevin playing an action star version of himself alongside John Travolta in Die Hard, and Andy playing an animated version of himself alongside, who else, The Housewives. The Andy Cohen Diaries also streaming now. If it's travel and adventure you're looking for, Disney Plus just debuted Rogue Trip with host Bob Woodruff. And HGTV has a new inspirational home renovation show called Build Me Up. To watch our recent interview with the show's host, Orlando Soria, head to celebritypage.com. Happy viewing. That's today's Dish.
Time now for the latest daytime headlines. For that, we turn to Soap Opera Digest editorial director Stephanie Sloan. Hey, Stephanie, good to see you. Now, this was a big week as The Bold and the Beautiful returned with new episodes, and you've been talking with some of the newcomers to the show.
Yes, the show is back with a bang and two new actors in the mix. Tanner Novlund, probably best known to the TV audience as the actor in the Liberty Mutual commercials, has been hired to play the new role of Finn, a doctor who will prove to be a new love interest for Steffi. Now, Tanner is no stranger to Bold and Beautiful. His wife, Kayla Ewell, previously played the role of Caitlin. Delon Demetz has been hired as a recast for the role of Zenday, last played by Rome Flynn, who won an Emmy and went on to work on How to Get Away with Murder. Delon is a Harvard honors grad who tells us that he fell in love with acting when his mother made him take lessons in preparation for his college interviews. Look for Delon to cross paths with Kiara Barnes' Zoe.
And you also caught up with Christian Alfonso to talk more about her decision to leave Days.
Yes, Christian tells me that she had actually been thinking about leaving the show 4 years ago, but ultimately decided to stay. This time around, the time was right for her to go. Christian says she's not going to get a big send-off. She has already filmed her last episode. Christian says that when she made the decision to go, she felt a sense of relief. Look for her to last air in mid-October.
All right, sounds great. Thanks so much, Stephanie. For more stories like these, be sure to check out the latest issue of Soap Opera Digest.
Real celebrates the troubled life and legendary career of Gilda Radner this week on Autopsy, The Last Hours Of. The series shedding new light on how the beloved SNL star died. Celebrity Page has your first look.
Her early battle with her weight led her down a dangerous path.
As she grew up, Gilda's world became dominated by binge eating.
She used to do a thing on Saturday Night Live where she would talk about what she ate. It was called What Gilda Ate.
But the laughter masked a dangerous illness.
I was very aware of her eating disorder. I mean, I knew that she, every time she ate, she went into the bathroom.
I taught myself to throw up. I became bulimic before medical science had even given it that name.
By the time she's on Saturday Night Live, not only is she dealing with her own reflection in the mirror, but she's dealing with her reflection in the eyes of everybody else. And as a consequence, we see the eating disorders flare up.
Eating disorders like bulimia and anorexia nervosa can have catastrophic effects on the body and are one of the leading causes of death related to mental health problems.
See more on Autopsy, The Last Hours of Gilda Radner, Sunday night on Reels.
Up next, he's the action star who's actually an expert in martial arts. Our conversation with Scott Adkins on his new thriller, ahead on Celebrity Page TV.
Time for more hot headlines in the Celebrity Page feed. Here's our social producer, Ricky Cornish.
'Tis the season for Christmas in July. If you're sick of being at home or just sick of the summer heat, now you can escape to a winter wonderland on Hallmark Channel.
The queen of films during the holiday season right now. You've got how many holiday films out now?
Three.
That's actress Jen Lilly talking with BJ Koros from Shout Out for a Cause at the Salvation Army Celebrity Kettle Christmas event. Jen starring in multiple Christmas movies for Hallmark, including Angel Falls, A Novel Holiday.
Home isn't a place on the map, it's a feeling in your heart.
It doesn't shy away from the real emotional raw moments, but at the same time, it is Hallmark, so it's very uplifting, and it's just amazing.
Who isn't into Christmas?
I don't know, I'm kind of over it.
Jen also starring in Mingle All the Way, another one of the non-stop Christmas movies playing throughout July on Hallmark. And great news for Hallmarkies, the network just announcing they're producing 24 new Christmas movies. They'll kick off October 23rd, 2020. For more on Hallmark's holiday plans, head to our website at celebritypage.com.
Welcome back to Celebrity Page TV. I'm Sonia Isabel in New York City. Here's James Vaughn in Las Vegas.
Welcome back, Celebrity Page TV. British actor Scott Adkins has had supporting roles in blockbusters like Doctor Strange and The Bourne Ultimatum. And now he's front and center as the star of the movie Legacy of Lies. And he's telling our Hollywood insider Arthur Cade all about it.
Do you know what we're up against, right?
I want those files published.
We quit MI6. We had an agreement. You don't mess with our business. We don't mess with yours.
Scott Adkins doesn't just play a martial arts expert in the movies.
Welcome to another Scott Adkins power kicking tutorial.
He's also one in real life.
Two, one.
Now Scott really getting to show his skills in the new action thriller, Legacy of Lies.
Basically, it's an espionage thriller in the vein of a Jason Bourne film or a James Bond film.
Scott playing a former MI6 agent who teams up with a journalist to uncover Russian secrets while also trying to protect his daughter at home.
There is a lie, a legacy of lies that this whole thing is built upon. Something tragic happened in the past and that whole situation is bust wide open.
As a trained gymnast and martial artist, Scott isn't easily impressed when it comes to Hollywood action stars, but he does have a few favorites.
Halle Berry in John Wick, I mean Charlize Theron in Atomic Blonde.
But the man he reserves the most praise for?
Well, you gotta say Keanu Reeves, I think, because he's done it the most. I mean, he bust the doors wide open with The Matrix. And now that he's doing the John Wick films, and he also directed Man of Tai Chi, which was a martial arts film. You've got to tip your hat to Keanu Reeves as the guy that does it the best.
And when it comes to his own success and huge social media following, Scott has a simple theory.
The thing about action films is they travel well. So, you know, you don't need subtitles to understand what's happening when somebody's punching someone in the face.
You can see Scott do a lot of punching when Legacy of Lies hits DVD and digital starting July 28th. For Celebrity Page, I'm Arthur Cade.
When we come back, HBO preparing to say goodbye to Room 104. A look at the final season next on Celebrity Page TV.
Queen is just my everything. Right now, I wouldn't know where my life would be without her.
They say chivalry's dead. It's not. Terrence is a gentleman. He opens doors. His smile did it. His smile, his eyes, his knowledge. My landlord, he decided that he wanted me to move based on the fact that I was transgender. It takes me to a place of no hope. It takes me to a place of loneliness. It saddens me. When you discriminate against somebody in housing, where do these people go? Let's just respect people in everyday life for just being human.
Welcome back to Celebrity Page TV. The anthology series Room 104 is returning to HBO for its fourth and final season. Our friends at Ranker.com are giving us a preview and telling us what else is watchworthy. Room 104 is an incredibly inventive show from Jay and Mark Duplass, and its fourth and final season is being released on July 24th. Every episode of the HBO show follows a different set of characters staying in the same hotel room, and the genre varies from horror to comedy depending on who's checking in. One sign that you're a future Room 104 fan is if you love Castle Rock, a horror anthology series set in the main town where many of Stephen King's stories take place. The show features characters and plot lines from King's novels, but uses them to tell entirely new, thrilling stories. If you're a fan of horror, you'll find plenty to keep you on the edge of your seat in Room 104. But since Room 104 is such a genre-bending show, it also appeals to comedy fans. For example, it's 9 times more likely that you'll love Room 104 if you're currently a fan of Black Monday. While some episodes are funnier than others, people who get Black Monday's sense of humor are far more likely to get a kick out of Room 104. Lastly, big fans of This Is Us should give Room 104 a try. Fans of This Is Us will appreciate the kind of inventive approach that this HBO series takes. If you're drawn to any of these recommendations, whether they're comedies, horror, or dramas, we seriously recommend checking out Room 104 as its final season approaches. But if you're still not sure, download the Watchworthy app. In just 30 seconds, it can tell you just how likely it is that you'll love the show, as well as give you dozens of recommendations just for you. Lots of great ideas. Well, that's going to do it for us. For James Vaughn and the entire Celebrity Page team, I'm Sonia Isabel. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.